There are over a half million women working in the fields of America. Most are undocumented immigrants. This is a story about the price many women pay to keep those jobs and to keep food on our tables.
La persona que nos ofreció el trabajo le dijo a mi papá, no, pues no tengo trabajo para usted. Pero dijo, pero para sus hijas sí tengo trabajo. Entonces ya desde ahí empezó, cuando estábamos en el FIC, le empezaban a acosarnos horriblemente.
Nos miran como que ellos son los dueños de uno y que a la hora que ellos quieren tenerlo a uno, lo pueden tener.
No sé hablar inglés. No tengo papeles para trabajar. Así que, pues tengo que aguantar.
Ni al control, porque era un mayordomo, él era el que mandaba.
Una vez más, siguió y siguió y siguió.
Entonces, cuando no accedes, no tienes trabajo a la temporada que viene.
Todo el mundo tenía miedo. Pueden hacerme daño o hacer daño a mi familia.
Harassment is part of the job, so to speak. Women are looked at as sex objects when they're out there in the field. Sexual harassment is an epidemic in the fields, and it again goes back to the vulnerability that women have, the farmworker women have. They work in isolated places. Many of them don't speak English. A lot of them don't even know the laws. They don't even know that they can report sexual harassment and that the employer can be responsible for that. And so they feel helpless.
If people were actually to understand the vulnerability that undocumented women are subjected to, one phone call and you'll be deported. I mean, let's recognize something. 1,400 people are deported every day from the United States of America. There is fear and real terror in the immigrant community.
Hundreds of charges by farm workers have been received nationwide, and they continue to come in all around the country.
How many criminal charges have resulted from all this?
I don't know of any criminal prosecutions that have been put forward in any of these farm worker cases.
Zero, as far as you know.
Zero, as far as I know, yeah.
For many women, fear continues in the fields. Mari Cruz Ladino was one of the few who had the courage to sue her employer. And after 4 long years, she settled her lawsuit.
No es tanto por lo económico. Porque eso no te devuelve la integridad como mujer, el valor como mujer. Se me escuchó. Por eso pienso que sí hubo justicia. Pero se murió una parte de mí. Y eso no se puede devolver. Estoy mirando que esto no nomás a mí me está pasando. Le está pasando a muchas, muchas mujeres. Y si uno se queda callado, va a seguir. Es por eso que ahora prefiero hablar, que en mí muchas personas o muchas mujeres se reflejen y no se queden calladas, que reaccionen. No con violencia, sino de que hay leyes que las protegen. Estén con documentos o sin documentos. Tiene que hablar.
So the Bandana project started, I believe, in the Midwest, and it's been going on around the country.
It's art as a healing tool for women that don't have the money to go to a counselor or to go to a psychiatrist. One time, this woman stayed and stayed and stayed after the meeting. And then she comes up to me and she asked me for 4 bandanas. On the last bandana, she drew 1 big, ugly monster face and said, that's the abuser, that's the one that's been, you know, abusing me every day at work, humiliating me. She kept saying that over and over. She had had a horrible situation out in the field, and it was eating her up.
The Bandana Project was something that allowed them to express it, to talk about it. And through discourse, that's where you find solutions, where you find self-esteem, where you find confidence.
I have seen the growth, development in her from how she was at the beginning to how she is now. It's amazing. Her self-esteem is so high because of that. She came forth and filed a lawsuit against that abuser. She won her lawsuit, and she got the strength because of the Bandana Project. I regard her as a very brave woman.